What up, y'all? So I'm out here at the Larkwood property, the six-figure flip, as I like to call it, and we are making some really tremendous progress on this one. So what I want to do is kind of show y'all the progress we've made so far and also some tips on managing the rehab itself, how you can do that, and then also some of the already early on lessons that I feel like we'll have learned from this project. Let's go check it out. As y'all can see, we've made a ton of progress on this property. We opened it up and it's looking 10 times better than how it was looking before. If y'all remember when y'all walked into this house, it was a huge eyesore from the 1970s. You're walking into straight wood paneling and a compartmentalized floor plan. Like I said, it's 2021. People want open concept floor plans. So that's what we did with this one. We bust down that wall and you can see it is now completely wide open. We finished up the demo, fixed the foundation, put brand new electrical in, all the lighting is in, plumbing is in, and now we are going to move on to the next phase of the project. You have to know whenever you're opening up walls that sometimes you're gonna run into, especially with these houses built in the 70s and the 60s, a lot of the walls that you're gonna be taking down are load-bearing walls, meaning the walls are being used to also hold up the weight of the roof. So whenever you're gonna demo them, you need to make sure that the roof is being supported before you demo them. So that's essentially what this beam here is doing. It's a 22-foot long cedar beam. It's a huge, huge beam that was extremely expensive because lumber right now is, you know, there's a lumber shortage. So any type of wood is just ridiculously expensive. And then holding up that beam, we have two cedar columns here that we're gonna get to stain. See, originally what I wanted to do was to allow this beam to stay exposed. But because it's so long, because the span is so long, we couldn't find any wood to or any lumber that was big enough to be able to wrap it. So what we're gonna have to do is essentially sheetrock it and then paint it like the rest of the house, which is fine, but you know, it kind of kills it a little bit, but we're gonna still be able to stain these columns, and essentially what we're gonna do is match the floor. So it's gonna be that eyepiece. Whenever you do walk into this house, you're gonna see that thing that pops out and is just going to wow you as soon as you walk in. The beam would have been super dope. I'm telling you, the beam would have been dope, but we still gonna make it rock with just the cedar posts. Y'all, the kitchen is going to be the selling point of this property, right? Like I said, we're going to come in here and put a huge 10-foot slab right here. It's literally gonna span from all the way over here to 10 feet across to the other side of the kitchen. We're gonna install pendant lights over here in the ceiling that's gonna drop down along the length of the counter, and it's going to make it for a huge eating area in which you could probably fit 4 to 5 people here. So what we're gonna do with it is going to be a waterfall island. So essentially it's going to be granite or quartz all the way around, even on the sides of it. You're gonna be able to tuck a chair underneath. But see, what we're gonna do now is have a cooktop now on this side of that island and then have the eating area on the other side. We trench for a 225 electrical line, and now it's gonna run down here. And so on this opposite wall, we're gonna have the sink here, dishwasher here, and we're gonna have the oven and a microwave here. You can see that we have the 225 on the wall here. One thing that's really important whenever you're doing, you know, these level rehab projects, when you're opening up walls and laying things out, you need to come in here and draw your layout with your contractor. Make sure you're making a complete layout and you're on the same page as far as, you know, where everything is going to be down to the foot, right? We don't want to have any miscommunication in that aspect, because once it's done, you don't want to have to spend money to have to do it again. Very, very important that you're on the same page about that kind of stuff. Now here in the master bath, we did not have a lot of space to work with. So, you know, we had to come with it. We got to come with it all over the house, but especially in here, because we really didn't have a lot of space. So with every square inch, we got to make sure that we're putting high end materials and just really aesthetically pleasing things. Because when people walk in, we don't want them to comment on how small the bathroom is. We want them to be commenting on how immaculate it looks, right? So in here we have a kind of, it's a really dope style of tile. It's like a wavy tile in here. And it's just something that's going to kind of give the bathroom a little more character. See, we're going with a more modern type of vibe. So this is going to really flow in with the aesthetic and with the gray look we're kind of doing on this property. So they got the tile in. Next, we're gonna put the pebble flooring in here, and we're gonna do the flooring in here, put the vanities in here. We got the plumbing all routed up, and so it's gonna look super dope. I'm already excited. We're gonna put a barn door here, and it's just going to be completely 180 degrees different than how it is right now. Yo, so something that y'all gotta make sure that y'all are doing whenever y'all are getting into these rehabs is making sure that you are testing your paint colors. Cause what we did on this house is we bought a gray paint that we thought was going to be gray, but it actually looks green when it's actually applied. And that's typically what happens. Typically the paint color that you see in the store is not how it's going to actually turn out. So it's important that if you can, you test the paint color with a sample or something like that, at least before buying a whole bunch of it, right? Because then you can see, you can back up and see it in the light in its true application on the property and see how it can look. Because right now, this house doesn't look gray, it definitely looks green. And on a $450,000, $500,000 house, very few people are buying a greenhouse unless you really just know how to make that green really rock. And me personally, I don't know how to make a green rock out like that. The goal is to always choose colors that are going to be a unanimous, you know, consensus among most people as a good paint option, right? And something like a green or a yellow or, you know, a red or something that's just a little more loud, it's not gonna always be the best option for everybody, right? Even if it looks good, right? Even if you do make it rock out, some people are just not gonna like it because they don't like that color, right? So they're gonna see that house and instantly have some sort of, you know, non-affinity with that color. And so we don't want that. We wanna make sure that we're choosing things, especially, you know, even on the exterior and on the interior of the home that most people will like, right? Because you're selling, you don't know who's buying your property. You don't know what your end buyer likes. You don't know what the consumer is into, what that retail buyer is necessarily looking for. Right, so you have to make something that's generally appealing to most people. So now what we're gonna have to do is pretty much buy more paint and repaint this property. It's fine, it's not the first time it's happened, but I mean, it does happen sometimes when you're in real estate. But yeah, we're moving along with this one. We should be wrapping it up here in a couple weeks. Probably, hopefully by mid-May, we could wrap this one up and get it listed on the market right in time for summer. Guys, you wanna make sure that if you can, you're getting your properties listed during prime time, which is going to be spring and then also into the summer. That's when everybody's gonna be looking for houses. That's when people are moving. That's when the kids are out of school. And that's usually what dictates people's, you know, decision to want to buy houses. When are the kids usually getting out of school? So summertime is the best time. Listing it in the spring, listing it in the summer is always gonna be a good move. So that's what we're gonna do. So now that the sheetrock is done, we're gonna go ahead and texture the property. Got the electrical done, got the plumbing. Now we can go ahead and install the lights, install the plumbing fixtures, finish out the bathroom tiles, and then start, you know, painting the property and then also start getting the flooring in, kitchen cabinets, those kind of things, and kind of finishing this property up. So in the next one, I'm gonna show y'all the progress on that.